Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How are you guys? My name is Mahmoud. I'm an Arabic language tutor. I teach Quran and Arabic to non-native speakers. So if you'd like to have a listen online with me, Quran or Arabic, you can email me here at ustazmahmoud184@gmail.com. Today, inshallah, we're going to learn how to sing Arabic permanently. How to say permanently in Arabic language. And as we usually do, we'll take an example first. Please look at this sentence. The door was permanently open. The door was permanently open. How to say this sentence in Arabic? Well, we say كان الباب مفتوحا بشكل دائم. كان الباب مفتوحا بشكل دائم. كان was الباب the door مفتوحا open. بشكل دائم permanently كان الباب مفتوحا بشكل دائم. So permanently in Arabic language means بشكل دائم. بشكل دائم. And it comes after جملة. It comes in the end of جملة. Comes in the end of the sentence. So جملة and then بشكل دائم. And let's see some examples. Please look at the first sentence. She asked if he was going to stay here permanently. She asked if he was going to stay here permanently. How to say this sentence in Arabic? Well, we say سألت إن كان سيبقى هنا بشكل دائم. سألت إن كان سيبقى هنا بشكل دائم. سألت, she asked إن كان سا, if he was going to يبقى stay هنا here بشكل دائم permanently. سألت إن كان سيبقى هنا بشكل دائم. Okay, the second sentence. Please look. Are you planning to work there permanently? Are you planning to work there permanently? How to say this sentence in Arabic? Well, we say أتخطط للعمل هناك بشكل دائم. أتخطط للعمل هناك بشكل دائم. Okay. أتخطط لي. Are you planning to عملي work هناك there بشكل دائم permanently. أتخطط للعمل هناك بشكل دائم. Okay. The last sentence. Please look. He wanted to live in Mecca permanently. He wanted to live in Mecca permanently. How to say the sentence in Arabic? Well, we say أراد أن يعيش في مكة بشكل دائم. أراد أن يعيش في مكة بشكل دائم. أراد أن, he wanted to, يعيش, live, في مكة, in مكة, بشكل دائم permanently. أراد أن يعيش في مكة بشكل دائم. So permanently in Arabic means بشكل دائم. And as you saw in previous sentences, it comes in the end of جملة. Comes after جملة. And that's the end of our lesson today. I hope it's useful for you, inshallah. Please don't forget to like this video and subscribe for the channel. And if you could share this video with your friends, I'll be really grateful for this. If you have any question, please write in the comment and I will reply to you. Don't forget to make dua for me and for my family. Thank you, and I see you in other lessons, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.